It's a 62 CBS Sports Special presentation. Detroit 62 CBS, big time TV. Now, Detroit 62 CBS, your place for big time sports events, brings you a 62 CBS Spartan Championship Special. All the slams, the jams, and the fans. Hear from players and coaches as they preview the national championship. And now, live from Indianapolis, Mark Wilson and Greg Kelser.
Yes, it is. Yes, it is championship night in Indianapolis, live at the RCA Dome on Final Four Road in Hoop City. It's the first collegiate national championship of the 21st century. Can Michigan State University win just the second collegiate basketball championship in school history? I think the University of Florida will have something to say about that. Hi again, everybody, and welcome to our Spartan Championship Special. And we're glad to have this for you with the trains going behind us here at the RCA Dome. It's a wild night indeed, a lot of excitement. And joining me tonight, a guy who was on the Michigan State team back in 1979. I think he helped out a little bit as Michigan State won that first national championship that year over Indiana State, Gregory Special K. Kelser. I know this is a big night for you too, Gregory.
It is. You know, a lot of my former teammates have come back. We're very proud to be here in support of these guys, and we understand how important this is. They set a goal early in the season, and now they got a chance to make it come true.
I mean, this is so special. You know what it's like. You played with another guy named Irvin Johnson,
yeah,
Judd Heathcote in the group, Bobo yeah. Charles, Jay Vincent, Terry Donnelly, all helped that national championship. We'll talk more about that later. But what are the guys thinking right now?
I'm sure they're just anxious to play. You know, one of the toughest stretches is that period of time between winning the semifinal game and then waiting till Monday night to play the championship game, because you're so close, you can feel it, you want it. I guarantee you many of them were ready to play right after the game was over, the semifinal game, but you have to wait, you have to be patient, and then you have to go out and execute your game plan.
Well, there are a lot of Spartans from all over the country that are here, certainly from East Lansing, all over the state of Michigan. They're tailgating even as we speak now in front of the RCA Dome here. And one of those Spartan fans that is so happy to be here in Indianapolis is a guy who knows Tom Izzo very well. And he, of course, is the head coach of the San Francisco 49ers, Steve Mariucci. And you have done so many interviews today already, Steve, simply because of the fact Steve Mariucci knows Tom Izzo. Here he is, a couple of guys who know what it's like to be a part of championships and know what it's like to win things. But you've got to be a little bit nervous for your old buddy Tom, don't you?
I'm nervous. Aren't we all a little bit nervous?
Yeah. Well, you got a couple of Spartans sitting here.
I know, and like Greg said, I think everybody, Tom Izzo included, anxious to play this game. It's been a long time coming. His goal has been to get to this national championship game and win it. And here it is, and they'd love to get started.
Steve, you go back to the Upper Peninsula with Tom. You guys up in Iron Mountain and Northern Michigan University. This is almost a culmination of a dream for him, and I know for you too, because you wanted it so badly for him.
You know, he started dreaming about this, you know, winning a national champion as a coach as soon as he began realizing he wasn't going to be a professional basketball player. And he got into coaching because he loves being around athletes and teaching and coaching, that type of thing. And so this has been a dream for Tom for 20 years or so. And he's got a chance. He's this close right now, and he can taste it. And, you know, and I just had a chance to talk to him in the hotel room, and I just told him, Tom, just will you relax? Because this is not the last time you're going to be back here. You're going to do this again sometime, so enjoy it. Try to enjoy it. It's a great thing.
Steve, what is the coach going through right now? If the players have a little bit of butterflies, if they're a little bit nervous, what's the coach? Because he always seems so cool, calm, collected.
I don't let that kid you. He's a nervous wreck.
Oh, good. I wanted to hear that.
No, he's continually, and like Greg said, it's a long day today. They had their shoot-around this morning. But as a coach, you review your plan over and over again, and you try to keep thinking about the game. And sometimes it's easier just to go ahead and play it early in the afternoon. But he's well-prepared. I sat in some of the meetings with him till late hours of the night, and they're very, very well-prepared.
Steve, I guess we have to ask you a prediction. We can't let you go without that. You got the Florida Gators here, very tough team. Team that outscores its opponent by about 14, 15 points a game. Michigan State out-rebounds everybody they play. Do you think Michigan State is up to the challenge here, and is Tom Izzo walk away here with that beautiful trophy?
Yeah, I'd love to see that. I'm not going to make any predictions because that's why we play the game.
Come on.
But I know this. It's a completely different game and scheme that the Wisconsin Badgers posed the other night, that defensive struggle. This is going to be a wide-open kind of game. They're going to fast break and press, and it's going to be a running kind of game. They shoot the threes like crazy. They're young and they're fresh. They play 10 players. It's going to be an exciting type of game, not a defensive slowdown game. But I'm confident that Michigan State is better prepared and better primed to do this. They're more experienced at tournaments than Florida may be at this point.
Gregory, this guy's a basketball coach here.
He knows his stuff.
You know what I'm saying?
He really does.
Why are you wasting your time with the 49ers in football there, buddy?
I coached a JV basketball game for Tom one time when he was at Ishpeming High School.
I got you. Yep.
Okay. Steve, thank you very much. I know you want to get inside. I know you want to enjoy this. You want to soak all this in the RCA Dome. Good luck to you tonight, too, I guess we could say, for your buddy Tom.
Thanks, Brad.
Steve Mariucci, the head coach of the San Francisco 49ers and longtime friend of Tom Izzo. We have so much more to go on our championship special, Gregory Kelser and I. We're going to come back and we're going to talk about, yeah, the task at hand, what the Spartans have to do to beat Florida, and what Florida may have to do to get Michigan State, if that's possible. It's next on Detroit 62 CBS as our Spartan Championship special just gets going.
This 62 CBS Spartan Championship special is sponsored in part by Big Net. Detroit 62 CBS, big time TV.
And welcome back to the RCA Dome in Indianapolis, Indiana, our Spartan Championship special. I'm Mark Wilson along with Gregory Kelser. We were so glad to be joined by the head coach of the 49ers and Tom Izzo's best friend. They were best man at each other's wedding, Steve Mariucci. And Gregory, I think the task now is to see if Michigan State can get all that stuff in their head about the season, close games with Utah and Syracuse and Iowa State out of their head, concentrate on Florida.
Well, they've got to come out and know that the Florida Gators are going to pose a different task. They're going to play an up-tempo. It's going to be markedly different than the game they played against Wisconsin. Keep in mind,
right,
their mindset against Wisconsin, they knew it was going to be an ugly game. They knew they probably would not look good in that game. But the whole idea was to survive and advance, and that's what they did. Now they can get up and down the floor, play their type of game, try not to turn the basketball over much, and score in transition, get the easy baskets that they'd normally get, and wear Florida down. That may be difficult. Florida plays a lot of players, but I think if this game is close, obviously the experience that Michigan State has and that Florida lacks could be telling.
Well, Michigan State, of course, led by the Flintstones. That means Mateen Cleaves and Charlie Bell and Morris Peterson and all the honorary Flintstones like A.J. Granger and Andre Hudson. Speaking of Andre Hudson, he kicks off our Spartan players that we interviewed this week. Of course, it was just a day ago because Michigan State won that game, that semifinal game, and then went on to think about the championship game with Florida. So here's Michigan State, the Spartans, talking about their task at hand tonight.
We've had a long, tough season, and we've had some injuries and things like that, but we played so many different styles of teams that, you know, we feel that we can play with anybody in this country, and I think that's been a big key to our success. You know, our preseason schedule was so tough, and we played so many different teams that, you know, we're used to playing different styles.
It's a dream. One thing I would say is, ever since I was little, this is where I want to be, with a group of guys that I even like and would love to go into a championship game.
This time last year, I was in the stands watching the Final Four, and just to be able to come out and play, you know, and contribute to the team in the win, I mean, it's a great feeling. And now to step back and realize 40 minutes separates you from the national championship, I mean, that's what I've been dreaming about since I was a kid.
I think we're going to be excited. I think this is what we've been working for all summer long, all season long, and, you know, especially with our seniors, we want to send those guys out, you know, with the national championship, you know, send them out with a bang. And it's going to be special, you know. We want to go out there and just play well.
I just want our team to be known as national champs, you know. And if you want to leave a legacy or something of that sort, you just got to go out there and win. You know, the name of the game is win. People can say ugly wins or whatever, but if you win, then people will always respect you. And I mean, if that's in life, whatever. If you're a successful person, people will always respect you.
It's special. It's like a dream, you know, just being in this situation, being in the Final Four and being able to play in a national championship game, because I think that's what makes people special, doing things that a lot of people can't do. And it's been like a dream, you know, just knowing that there's been a lot of, you know, great players playing in the Final Four, winning a national championship, and I think we want a piece of the pie too.
All right, Michigan State knows what they have to do. Now, Wisconsin posed certain problems to the Spartans, obviously, in the semifinal game, Gregory. For Michigan State, that Florida press really is something that you're going to see a lot of tonight when we hit the game running about 9:18.
Well, you know, I've watched Michigan State play a lot this season, and I haven't seen many teams pressure them. And I anticipate that if Florida comes out trying to do that with ball handlers like Mateen Cleaves and Charlie Bell, Michigan State should be able to score easy buckets. I don't anticipate that they'll have problems attacking the pressure. They should welcome it, in fact.
Well, here's Steve Mariucci's best friend, Tom Izzo, on Florida's press.
Billy's done a great job. I think they're very well coached, and they do an incredible job of what we call back tipping. They come up from behind, knock balls loose, like good pressing teams do. I think number two, they have very good athletes, and you have to have great athletes to run that kind of press. And number three, they have depth. So the good athletes are always fresh athletes because he does a great job of substituting them. So I think those three factors are the reason that press is effective.
Are you going to have it replaced?
Okay. So Tom Izzo knows what it takes to get rid of that Florida press, if he can even do such a thing there, Gregory. But now the Florida Gators, here's a team that's very young. They employ no seniors in that starting lineup most of the time. And they really are a team of sophomores and juniors. Maybe they don't even know they're supposed to be here, Gregory.
Well, I disagree with that. I think they expect to be here. After all, they have a lot of confidence in their abilities. But they're fortunate to be here because they were just a hair within losing their first round game,
right,
against Butler.
Correct.
But since that time, they've gotten better. They've gotten more confident. And they've managed to avoid the tight games at the end. But I still think that if this game is close, experience sometimes is overrated. But I think in tournament situations like this, if it's close at the end, then that experience can step up and help you. And that certainly was the case when Michigan State fell down in the second half, both to Syracuse and Iowa State.
Well, here's some names you have to remember tonight. Miller, Wright, Dupay, and Haslam. Let's talk about Florida, and let's hear from the Florida Gators.
Throughout this tournament, we've been doing a pretty good job of getting to the glass and starting to break. And I don't see why it should be any different against Michigan State. You know, they go pretty big. And I think we got a pretty big guys. I think Mike leads us in rebounding at the three guards. So we definitely want to try to get to the backboard so we can start to break and get the game going up and down.
They got a great basketball team. Mateen Cleese is going to lead them as best he can. And, you know, I think they have a lot of other leaders besides him also. So, you know, it's just going to be a good basketball game.
You know, we won some games here, you know, but I think people still are kind of doubting us. You know, saying you can't press. Why do you guys play 10 players?
I think that this game, because of the limited time for preparation, that a lot of this is going to take for both teams a tremendous amount of mental toughness, character, heart, and guts.
Billy Donovan, of course, the head coach at the University of Florida. He's been to the Final Four with Providence. We'll talk more about that later. He knows exactly what his team has to do tonight. Now, I think you know the guy that's to the right of me. We're going to take a quick one, come back, and talk to the head coach of the Michigan State Spartans when they won the national championship 21 years ago. I think you two have met. Maybe you can get reacquainted in the time we're gone. Our Spartan Championship special rolls on live from the RCA Dome in Indianapolis. That's next. Judd Heathcote right here. He's next up. It is our Spartan Championship special here at the RCA Dome, and just what about, a little less than an hour now from Michigan State and Florida. Mark Wilson and Gregory Kelser on this championship special on Detroit 62 CBS, and we're so thrilled to be joined by the guy who actually coached this guy to a national championship 21 years ago. Does it feel like 21 years? Judd Heathcote joining us.
Well, the way my hip feels, it feels like 100 years, Mark and Gregory, but you know, time flies, and it really doesn't seem that long ago.
Gregory, tell me right off the bat now how tough it was to play for him during that time, during that year.
I got to say it while he's here?
Yes, you do. Absolutely.
Listen, playing for Coach Heathcote was not the easiest thing, and I make no secret about that because he was very demanding. But you know what? When you're in the midst of that, sometimes it's difficult to understand. But once you get out of it and you mature a little bit, you say to yourself, hey, I needed him. I needed him to get to the point that I was able to get to achieve the potential that I had. I mean, he made me work, and sometimes he made me dislike him. But tell you what, Mark, if I had it to do all over again, I'd go right back to Michigan State and play for Judd Heathcote. No question about that.
Well, I know he likes to hear that, and I'll never forget this. I'll never forget the loss to Northwestern by 18 points. I hate to bring it up to you. You were 4-4 at the time. Look at the face. You were 4-4 at the time. Did you think that was national championship team?
Why are we bringing that up?
But that was a turning point maybe in the season when that loss came, and then all of a sudden, boom, you didn't lose again other than the Wisconsin game all season.
Well, we went on a roll. We played our best basketball. We made a change, actually, in the starting lineup, putting Mike Berkovich in instead of Ron Charles, when Ron Charles was actually playing very good basketball. But we needed another ball handler. We had a meeting. We dedicated ourselves to tougher defense, better rebounding, and everything kind of fell in place after that.
Well, there's a story that a guy who was also here, a young man named Irvin Magic Johnson, told about Coach Heathcote, and we had a chance to pick up on that story. So take a listen to Irvin Magic Johnson here in Indianapolis telling the story he has about Judd.
I used to always have the music on. I can recall this like it was yesterday. So at a certain point when Judd walked into the locker room, we always had to cut the music off. So as soon as I cut the music off, you know, now Jug goes to the board and he's gonna diagram, you know, the strategy and so on and on. So I cut the music off and, you know, here he comes. And he said, E? I said, yeah, coach. What are you doing? I said, no, I just cut the tape off. Hell, cut that music back on. So everybody's like, and we didn't know if he was kidding or what, you know, I'm sitting there like, okay. So I hit the music and we're getting ready. So we look up and there's nothing on the board, you know? And he said, okay, cut the music off. Cut the music off. Hell, let's just go out and kick the ass.
Very funny story from Irvin Magic Johnson. And I mean, that's probably one of the reasons, maybe not, but certainly a lot of reasons why you won that championship 21 years ago.
Well, I thought we were a little tight that day. I thought maybe that would loosen us up a little bit. We went out and played just an unbelievable game against Notre Dame. And I think Gregory would attest to this. That was probably the championship game. Notre Dame was the second best club in the country at that time. Great pro players for the future. And we played our best basketball.
Before we let the coach go, I really want to know, both you and Gregory together, what does it mean now, 21 years later, and are these guys going to go through the same kinds of things tonight?
Well, I think I said after the game, I told the players that this will mean more to you as time passes. We had our 20th year reunion of the championship team last year, and almost to a man, they said, hey, it means more and more as time passes. And I think this will be the same. It's an opportunity of a lifetime. It's something to win, to cherish, to keep. Because, believe it or not, guys, nobody remembers who got second. And so first place is what they're playing for. First place is what they're going to get.
Same thing, Gregory?
Absolutely. There's no question. It's still very, you know, it seems to get bigger and bigger in significance as the years go by. People still talk about it like it was yesterday. And I agree with Coach. It's nice to get to the Final Four, but you really have to win it in order to really make it something significant.
Beating Indiana State and Larry Bird at the Huntsman Center in Salt Lake City, I'll never forget that. And after being with you for 14 years doing a coach's show, I'm not going to ask you who you pick tonight. I know who you go with. We'll take a break on our Spartan Championship special on Detroit 62 CBS. And when we come back, a look at the coach's wife, not Judd's wife, Tom Izzo's wife, the lovely Lupe Izzo, as we continue here live from the RCA Dome in Indianapolis. Don't go anywhere. Back live from the RCA Dome in Indianapolis, Mark Wilson and Greg Kelser on your Spartan Championship special on Detroit 62 CBS. And then behind every great man, behind every great coach, there's a great woman, and Tom Izzo is no exception. His lovely wife, Lupe, is so excited about this simply because she's an East Lansing person. She went to Michigan State. She graduated there. She is excited, as her husband, as anybody is, about this championship night. We had a chance to visit with Lupe Izzo. Behind most successful coaches, there is a successful point guard. But there's also a successful woman. Tom Izzo's wife of 9 years, Lupe, is without question the first lady of Spartan basketball.
He does all the coaching, but we talk about
X's and O's.
Yeah, no X's and O's. No, but yeah, we do talk about the game, and we both, you know, he respects that I understand the game, and yeah, there's a lot of conversation.
It's been great, you know. My first date with her was kind of here, right there in that row, on the fourth row, because
I remember.
Yeah, it was back when we played Purdue in '90, and she was one of the, I won't say rare girls, but she was a girl that enjoyed basketball. She used to go to some Piston games and things like that.
Now you can't go to a Spartan game without spying the MSU graduate near her husband. Yes, she has a wide range of emotions. Lupe tries to have fun, but
last week, it was the nerves that won out. But most of the time, it's the fun.
And the fun is why Tom and Lupe's daughter, Raquel, makes the games now. And at 5, she knows the deal.
She knows the players. She knows the mom. She knows the grandpas.
She knows what you're playing for?
Does she understand what a national championship is? She was at the last Final Four. She felt it, you know.
Lupe says it's been the fulfillment of a dream to get this far, but you have to push the coach's wife just a little to get her to admit that MSU now ranks with the elite programs in America.
I don't think that we have to stop there. I think it's something that you have to continue working at all the time. So, Mark.
I just wanted to say it's an elite program now.
It's an elite program.
We kind of treat our players like part of the family and the parents and all the other things. And she's done a great job because she has to do a lot of the behind-the-scenes things. And I've appreciated that.
It is a wonderful relationship. But let's not forget that Lupe was a Spartan fan long before she met Tom Izzo. And the Final Four means everything.
Nobody can understand that kind of adrenaline that goes through you when you just see that it's you that's there. And along with that comes a lot of spotlight.
How will you feel, Lupe? Monday night, cutting down the nets, no more games left to be played, final one and you're the national champion. Can you even think about it?
If that really happens, I'm going to enjoy every minute of it.
Gregory, she's a wonderful person, and she really is the woman behind the man, isn't she?
Well, no question about it. She's sweet, she's lovely, and also anytime you're the wife of a coach, there's a great deal of sacrifice that goes on because the coach is gone so often, and oftentimes the family seems to be second on the priority list, but she does a wonderful job.
Gregory and I will be back in a moment to talk with the guy who's covered the Spartans all year. Dave Dye from the Detroit News joins us next as our championship special rolls on again, live from the RCA Dome in Indianapolis. We're just, I don't know, it's pretty close now to that Florida-Michigan State game.
Let's get it on.
Don't go anywhere. Michigan State and Florida from the RCA Dome behind us here in Indianapolis. Mark Wilson and Greg Kelser are now happy to be joined by a guy who covers the Spartans for the Detroit News and a guy I have known since he got to Michigan State a year after we were all at the Huntsman Center in Salt Lake City watching these guys, Gregory and Magic, win a national championship. You missed it by a year, buddy.
Day late and dollar short, story of my life right there, right?
But you remember it really well, and you remember that time period for Michigan State. Do you think these guys are going through the same thing that those guys might have gone through? Is because of the media hype and all the things now, Dave, surrounding basketball, does that make a difference now?
I think it makes a big difference. I can't believe that the press conferences and just the whole build-up for three straight weeks was anywhere near what it is now 21 years ago. Not even close.
Dave, you saw the semifinal games, and of course Florida went out, beat North Carolina, but were able to play their style in winning that game. Now Michigan State, they didn't look their best. They had to grind it out against Wisconsin. Everyone knew what to expect in that matchup. But now people are wondering, hey, Florida looked really good on Saturday. Michigan State looks sluggish. Is there a reason that Spartan fans perhaps should be a little concerned?
I think this is a great matchup for them. They like to run. I thought the dangerous game was Wisconsin because it's such a different kind of style. They're going to need to get a little bit more out of their bench, I think, tonight because Florida is so deep with 10 players. And I think the guy to look for, he didn't do anything Saturday. No points, no rebounds, no shots. Jason Richardson, it wasn't his type of game. This is his type of game. I look for him to be the X factor again. I think Jason Richardson's going to give them what they need off the bench tonight.
Well, Dave, Gregory brought up a great point, and the fact is that Michigan State has had a lot of bad basketball. They've played a lot of first half bad basketball. They've been sluggish at times. Do they have to play their best to win games? It doesn't seem like they do.
No, they have so many different ways of winning games, and they've shown that they are the most complete team in the NCAA. I think if they win today, then that's what they've shown, that they can beat you anyway. They can beat you the slowdown way, they can beat you the fast way, and anything in between.
When you talk about Florida, everyone wants to speak about their depth, the fact that they play 10 players, everybody gets
Absolutely.
A significant amount of minutes. But Michigan State has a deep bench, too. But is Florida's bench such that you would give them the edge in the bench matchup?
I think you have to going into the game because they've been more productive throughout the tournament. Michigan State's bench, really, they have talent, but they have not been that productive throughout the tournament, even though for quite a bit of the season. But I think they're capable. I think Jason Richardson's capable. Mike Chappelle came on and played a decent game, gave him a few solid minutes against Wisconsin. He's another guy who could step up tonight and help him.
Dave, you watch a lot of college sports. What does a national championship now mean to a university like this? I know it means a lot for alumni donations. Freshman enrollment is up at Michigan State. What else does it mean? Does it mean a recruiting edge for years for Tom Izzo now?
Well, I think he's got that going anyways, but I think it's if they win tonight, people are going to say that they are an elite program. They've been to two straight Final Fours, three straight Sweet 16s, but you got to win that championship, and Izzo knows it, and his players know it, and I think that this is something that if they win it this year, then he could roll for the next 10 years or so.
Dave Dye from the Detroit News. Thank you very much, David. I know you want to enjoy this one, too, being a former Spartan. So we'll see what you have a good time and good luck yourself with this thing. I know you'll have a good time with that. So good time for everybody in the national championship, including the writers. Dave Dye from the Detroit News joining us on our Spartan Championship special. Gregory and I'll have much more next from the RCA Dome in Indianapolis. We're live. Don't go anywhere. We are back live at the RCA Dome in Indianapolis, just minutes away now from the national championship. Michigan State going for their second all-time. Gregory Kelser along with me, Mark Wilson. We're glad to be joined now by the guy you see late night after David Letterman. It's the Late Late Show. Can I do it just like you do it?
Yeah.
It's Craig Kilborn.
Don't reveal it. It's somebody behind the curtain that announces. Can I ask you guys a question?
Sure.
Is Billy Donovan serious about pressing Mateen Cleese?
Ooh, he knows a little bit about basketball.
Judd Heathcote, before he left, said, that'll end in about 5 to 10 minutes.
You cannot pressure Mateen. Am I right? By the way, I grew up in Minnesota, so I always root for the Big Ten. Michigan State all the way.
You're a Montana State guy, right?
Led the Big Sky in
turnovers. Judd used to coach at Montana.
Yeah. I led the Big Sky in turnovers at Montana State in Bozeman. I was a step
slow. Bless you for that.
I was a slow white player. I still am. And I had a scholarship, but I didn't play defense. Greg, it didn't interest me defense.
Well, it didn't interest me either.
No, believe me.
I played for Judd, so I had no choice.
Yeah.
As is the case with a lot of the players that play for Coach Izzo. But to answer your question, we haven't seen many teams pressure Michigan State in the full court this season.
Yeah.
And with ball handles like Mateen Cleaves and finishers like Morris Peterson, we anticipate that if Florida comes out with that, they'll get a lot of easy baskets.
I think it's going to be fun. The game the other night, I'll be honest, was dreadful. I think
Wisconsin game?
Yeah, Wisconsin brings you down to their level. I mean, they
sure
work hard.
Right.
You know, again, I root for the Big Ten. I like Wisconsin, but their style was bad. But I can't wait to see Florida, their style, they're going to make. Peterson's going to go nuts tonight.
Let's remind everybody that Craig Kilborn worked at ESPN. You did a little sports at some of those little stations in California somewhere. I remember that.
Yeah, I mean, people are probably watching saying, why is he talking hoop? I love the
hoop. You're a big hoop guy. Yeah. You're a big hoop guy. I know that. You talk about on the show all the time.
I didn't go to class. I just played ball. And I don't know why I wasn't a better ball player, because I didn't go to class.
Now, you say you're a Big Ten fan. You grew up a Big Ten fan?
Minnesota. I'm from the
big Michael Thompson, Kevin McHale group.
Michael Thompson.
Michael Thompson.
That's the number I wore. I had
43. Kevin, no chopped liver here, buddy.
43. I had Garnett on the show, on my show out in L.A.
Saw that.
Kevin Garnett. And he was telling me how he liked Malik Sealy at St. John's, and that's why Malik wore 21, and that's why KG wears 21. I said, I like Michael Thompson at Minnesota, and he wore 43. That's why I wore 43 in high school. No.
So Michael with a Y, Thompson?
Yes. Yeah. Absolutely. They were good. He was co-player of the year with Phil Ford. They were on probation. They were a good team.
You know your basketball.
A little bit, more than a little bit.
Yeah, I want Mateen. Not
you
a great. Bill,
are you really impressed with Mateen Cleaves? Do you think he's an NBA player?
Not at all. Can I say
you do
that?
Not think.
No, I think he's like Dwayne Pearl Washington. He is a great college player, but I don't think he's that great a shooter. I hope he makes it. I just think Peterson.
Battle him here. There.
Well, you know, a lot of people wonder about that and his potential for greatness or at least being a decent NBA player. But I liken him to a guy like Avery Johnson. Avery Johnson's a very poor shooter in the NBA. I mean, he doesn't even have a jump shot that you necessarily have to respect, but he's a leader and he knows how to win. And I think if Mateen can get on the right club like Avery, and it took Avery a little time to find the right club, then he can do well in the NBA. But so much depends on where he goes.
There are a couple guys who Mateen is the leader. He controls the tempo of the game. He's really strong with the ball. But there are a couple guys in the NBA like Jason Kidd who's learned to shoot. And I never thought Gary Payton was going to be this great a three-point shooter.
No, neither did I.
So maybe Mateen, he can certainly play defense and handle the ball. Maybe he can develop his shot in the NBA. Who knows?
You know, I was arguing with some people. They see Peterson going to the NBA and being a three-man, but I think he would do well in the two spot. Your thoughts?
I haven't seen him handle the ball enough, but his range is unlimited. You know, it reminds me of the Big Sky when we had the long three-point
range is unlimited, absolutely. No, it is. I'm not kidding you.
You're not believing any of this.
I am believing you.
I'm going to show you. There are three highlights of me from college when I didn't turn the ball over.
Are those the ones you show all the time?
It was in warm-up. That counts, warm-up.
Oh, yeah.
And
if you insist.
There was one night in Idaho in warm-ups every layup in the layup line.
Just a spud.
I made.
Oh, you damn.
I mean, I had 20 points in warm-up. That's all I had, Greg. I didn't get to play.
Well, Craig, you're doing well now. So
we can do this comedy all night. How's the show going, real quick?
Huge in Detroit, huge in New York, huge in L.A., huge in Indiana. It's huge in – it's going well.
Well, since we're going back to Detroit, can we get one O. Weber?
Do you remember
O. Weber.
That?
O. Weber.
He was rookie of the year after that. Everyone wanted Penny Hardaway. I said, no, it's going to be Weber. Oh, Weber.
I love it. Give me one of those looks into the camera there, will you? One of those,
I don't know what they are.
You know, those little – little wink, yeah.
Kelser's on fire.
He's Craig Kilborn. It's the Late Late Show on CBS. You see it right here at Detroit 62 CBS. We're back with Billy Packer. Talk a little more basketball. Thank you there, Craig.
Thanks, man.
All right.
Nice meeting you.
This 62 CBS Spartan Championship special will return right after this. Detroit 62 CBS Big Time TV. This 62 CBS Spartan Championship special is sponsored in part by Bell Tire. Detroit 62 CBS Big Time TV.
We are just about a half an hour away now from the national championship game, Michigan State and Florida, right here at the RCA Dome in Indianapolis. We'll see if Michigan State can do what the Spartans did 21 years ago when Gregory Kelser and Irvin Johnson were both all-tournament. I looked that up, and I knew that you guys were all-tournament. A guy who certainly knows college basketball maybe better than anybody else around is CBS's very own Billy Packer. We had a chance to sit with Billy, actually stand with Billy, and talk about the game, talk about Tom Izzo, and other things Spartan in Florida a little earlier today. All right, Billy, thank you for joining us. I appreciate it. Now the question that every Spartan fan wants an answer to. Has Tom Izzo hit that new realm, Billy? Is he now one of the elite coaches in college basketball?
Without question, Tom is putting himself in a position with the consistency that he's shown in the Big Ten and also with what he has coming in next year in terms of talent to make up for the losses that he has in this great senior class. I think that he is putting not only Michigan State, but he's putting himself in a position to be one of the premier programs in the country. He is a player's coach. He has great rapport with his players, and so therefore I would have the opinion that he is not going to be in it for a short term. I think that we're looking at Tom Izzo being a central figure in not only Big Ten basketball, but national basketball for many years to come.
All right, Billy, let's gauge the Florida Gators a little bit here. What kind of problems do Billy Donovan and those Gators, his team, present for the Spartans?
Well, one of the things that Billy has done, and he has been a tremendous learner in regard to being way ahead of his time in regard to his age. Rick Pitino installed a system at the University of Kentucky that became very successful and won a national championship. And in the case of Billy, he has followed up with that same type of system. He's bought into the fact that you're going to play the full 94 feet in both offense and defensive philosophy. You're going to play a lot of people. You've got confidence when they go into the game that they're going to get the job done. And his players have bought into that philosophy well. So if you play against a Florida, that's what they're going to do. And you have to figure out ways to not play their game. And that has been very difficult so far in this tournament because the bench has been so productive.
Billy, obviously of the four teams in the Final Four, only the Spartans were here last year and again this year. Did the experience of 1999 help them in this year's tournament run?
Absolutely. I think that one of the things that we have seen in their team this year is the refusal to lose games in which it looks like everything has gone awry for them. They have great senior leadership on this team. They are not as difficult to play against, I don't think, as last year's team without Antonio Smith in the middle. But every one of their players has played a lot better with a lot more confidence, a lot more determination. So maybe they're even a tougher out, even though they're not as hard to play against, if that makes any sense. I like this team a lot. I think they like each other. And Mateen sets the pace in terms of that competitive nature.
All right, in this tournament, Utah, Syracuse, Iowa State, have those close games, Billy, helped Michigan State?
You know, everybody seems to have theories after the fact. I don't believe in a lot of those theories. There is no formula. You know, there was a team in 19, let's see what year that was. I think it was 1979. I can't remember exactly what the school was. But they went through the NCAA tournament, and I think the closest team they played was 11 points, and that was in the final game, and it could have been 20 in that one. So I don't remember the name of the team, but I think that if you look back, they were the champions in 79. So there is no formula that guarantees that you've got to play some close games in order to be the champion. Was that Michigan State, by the way? Same team, that's right. Yeah. Yeah.
And I got to ask you that, Gregory. Does it make a difference that Michigan State has played close games? Do you think it'll help them tonight?
Well, I think it gives them at least the confidence that if they fall behind, that they can come back. That is what they've learned about themselves in this tournament. But I just don't think that,
no,
that they want that.
No, I don't think so either. I think they'll go for the 20-point blowout if they can. Although, you know what they say, all you got to do is win by one. Doesn't matter how ugly it is anymore. Win by one tonight, it doesn't matter. There's no more games. We'll take a quick break. We're getting a little closer to game time. And Tom Izzo will hear from the head coach himself his final thoughts before this championship game as we roll on live from the RCA Dome in Indianapolis. Don't go anywhere. Welcome back to our Spartan Championship special on Detroit 62 CBS. Mark Wilson and Greg Kelser. It's kind of the hours kind of flying by, isn't it, Gregory? Can you feel the anticipation building? It's fun to see all our friends, too, from East Lansing and whatnot around here.
The anticipation's been building for a long time. I mean, this city has been a buzz. As you walk around, it started on Saturday with a lot of powder blue for North Carolina, right. A lot of red for Wisconsin.
We got rid of
obviously,
them.
Yeah. Yeah, blue and orange for Florida.
We got rid of them.
And a lot of green for Michigan State. Now it's just green against blue. They've taken over this city. Tonight, someone's going to leave in tears. Someone's going to leave with right. jubilation.
And it has been a Spartan love fest. And one of the things they always talk about is how great a job Tom Izzo has done turning this program back into what it should be, an elite program in the country. Mark Champion had a chance to sit down with Tom and get his final thoughts as we head to this championship night.
Well, thanks, guys. Tom, 40 minutes. I mean, you've been talking about that. 40 minutes. Does it seem like 40 years at this point?
You know, it has been a long time, Mark. We started off after the Indiana game of 440 minutes because that's what we thought we had to play if we were going to win a national championship and win all the championships in between. We were able to accomplish all but the last 40, and I guess this is the biggest 40.
You know, I noticed that after the game, there was certainly happiness of reaching the championship game tonight, but not over. You know, there wasn't. I think the focus is still on this championship game, isn't it?
Well, it really is. I think Mateen has a lot to do with that. I think, and all of our seniors, to be honest with you, I think there's a sense that they want a certain thing, and I don't think they're going to be happy until they get it. And unfortunately, only one team will get it tonight. But let's hope it's us.
Well, you're going to see the anti-Wisconsin in the University of Florida. I mean, they move it up and down the court, and Billy Donovan uses 10 players to do it. The fact that you're seeing something completely different in such a short period of time, has it been tough getting ready for them?
Well, it hasn't. It hasn't, because we've played teams like that before. We've seen teams like this with Iowa in the past. Connecticut ran, you know, a lot of pressing on us, and we would like to get up and down the court too. So in that respect, it's going to be a blessing. Now maybe that'll work in a disadvantage to us, but at least going in, we're looking forward to it.
Well, one thing about it, in watching the semifinal game against North Carolina, the Tar Heels wore down. It's obvious they couldn't keep up with Florida, but I have a feeling your guys are ready. I mean, I know Mateen is. I mean, your fellows are in great shape.
I think we are in great shape, and I think you know, we've got a little deeper bench than North Carolina has, and it's no doubt our bench got to play a little better than it's played at times. But I think some guys are playing better, and I think they will play better. So we feel that, you know, with the timeouts you get in the NCAA right now, we don't see fatigue as being a factor.
Rebounding and defense, does the game come down to that once again?
You know, I think so. I hope we have to be a little bit better offensively than we were the other night, but I still think it will come down to rebound and defend, and that's usually wins championships in any sport, as you know, Mark.
Yep.
So we've done it that way for 31 victories. Why change now?
Morris Peterson stepped up in the national semifinal game, scored 16 of his 20 points in the second half. I mean, what a special player. Not only that he hit the boards probably more aggressively than I've seen him in a while.
I was just going to say, probably the bigger part was his defense and rebounding, you know, and that got his offense going. But you know, we went to him a little bit more. We went to him in the post a little bit more, which we haven't done recently, and he responded, and I guess that's what all Americans are supposed to do.
What do you expect? Do you think that Florida may change anything they do to try to, because they've got to know that you can keep up with them if it gets to be an up-tempo basketball game?
You know, I really don't. I think both teams have had success at what they do, and it's not like one team's a big favorite over the other, so I don't see a lot of changes. I think they may play a little more zone. They haven't done that a lot, but they may. But they'll still press some. If it's working, they'll pick it up. If it doesn't work, they'll probably lay off it a little bit more. And we're in the same boat.
Do you feel that you have an advantage because you have senior leadership and you've been to the Final Four before?
Well, I hope the senior leadership helps us. Unfortunately, the trip to the Final Four, even though maybe it would have helped us the first night, we're both in uncharted waters right now because neither one of us have ever played in a championship game. And when you get 37, 38 games into the season, you know, I think both teams have experience on what it takes to win big games.
Thank you, Mark Champion. Of course, thank you, Mark. And we just heard from Tom Izzo there. I want to remind everybody, if you want to check out all your championship happenings, don't forget to check out our website at WWJTV.com.
And, you know, Gregory, when you talk about Tom Izzo, you talk about a guy who's what now? 70 games over 500 already in his short Spartan head coaching career?
You know,
it's unbelievable.
It really is. How he's turned this program around so quickly in just his fifth year. Remember, third year he gets gets a Big Ten championship, repeats that, and gets a Final Four appearance last year, and now all the way into the championship game in a third straight Big Ten championship. He is really remarkable. But I think the biggest thing is he really got more actively involved in the recruiting, and now he's getting good athletes to come to wear the green and white.
What a great guy. Hey, what a way to end this thing. We got to wrap this thing up anyhow soon. Let's take a look at a musical piece, a musical look at Michigan State as they get ready for a championship game with Florida.
It would be better for me just to enter my name in the NBA draft and play basketball in the NBA in June. No, I'm just kidding.
We want to win championships, and what do I mean by championships? I mean every one we play in. And yes, it would mean the national championship.
And again, good evening from the Breslin Center. Good to be back with you, and here we go again. And Mateen looking to dish it in. Got it into Morris Peterson. Peterson jacks up the three. He buries it!
Gregory, give me a pick. I don't know why I'm asking you, but give me a pick anyhow.
Okay, you ready? I like Michigan State to win this game by 11 points.
All right, Gregory Kelsey, you see him on the Pistons game on Fox Sports Net Detroit. Don't miss him there. Thanks so much for joining us these past few weeks. We really appreciate it. For everybody here at Detroit 62 CBS, I'm Mark Wilson. Enjoy the game at the RCA Dome. We're gone from Indianapolis. Good night, everybody.
A national championship. Live from the RCA Dome in Indianapolis, a 62 CBS exclusive big-time sporting event with our own Michigan State Spartans. Next on Detroit 62 CBS, Big Time TV.